Moments of anticipation that feel endless. Then jubilation as the families of 18 female Palestinian prisoners receive their loved ones. Tears mixing with laughter as mothers, brothers, and loved ones reach out for a glimpse or a touch before a full embrace.
My feelings are a mix of joy and sadness because I left many prisoners behind, some serving life sentences, others who are ill, and many of our brothers, the prisoners. I call on the Shalit captors to conclude the deal as soon as possible.
Scenes also repeated in Gaza, where Fatima al-Ziq and her son Yusuf, who was born inside an Israeli prison, were released. These women's freedom from Israeli detention was secured in exchange for a video of the captured Israeli soldier Gilad Shalit, now entering his fourth year in captivity. But these moments of emotion for the families are also politically significant.
Conducted like a prisoner swap anywhere else in the world through the International Committee of the Red Cross, this limited release of 20 female Palestinian prisoners is being hailed and celebrated as a victory to Palestinian resistance factions.
Sentiments echoed by the freed prisoners.
I want to thank the resistance, and I call on them to release all the male and female prisoners as soon as possible, and I tell them to stay steadfast.
In Ramallah, the freed prisoners were transported to the presidential compound, where they were received by the Palestinian president. And in Gaza, deposed Hamas Prime Minister Ismail Haniyeh was also celebrating, calling this achievement a moment of national unity. Celebrations will last well into the night, but the efforts to conclude a full swap deal where Palestinians are hoping hundreds of prisoners will be set free are expected to last much longer. Hamas officials described the German-mediated negotiations as difficult and daily, but for the families of prisoners who remain behind Israeli bars, these negotiations are a source of hope. Nour Audi, Al Jazeera, Ramallah.